we can now save and load our graphs. That almost finishes up our dialog system. However, there still are two things left to do, the minimap and the custom inspector. We'll be doing our minimap first, as that will finish the editor window features. The minimap is simply a square that shows you every element that the graph has at the moment. It allows for navigation to those elements by clicking in the rectangles present in the minimap box. There are, I believe, limits on the amount of information that can be shown in the minimap at a time, but it can still be somewhat useful for someone, so I'll be adding it to our graph. Another useful feature for the graph is the F key. If you press on it, it will simply zoom out enough that you can see the whole graph. Thankfully for us, it will be quite simple to add our minimap to the graph, as Unity provides us with a minimap class that does everything automatically for us. So go to our DSGraphView script, and in here, in our constructor, we'll be calling in a new method which I'll name addMinimap. I'll place it under our addSearchWindow method in our elementsAddition region. In here, create a minimap by typing in minimap, and I'll name it minimap. I'm adding an uppercase M because the class does so as well. Then, call its constructor together with the object initializer. We'll be setting its anchored variable to true. If this variable is true, we will not be able to move our minimap around. If this variable is false, we'll be able to move it around our graph. If you want to be able to move it, simply don't pass in anything, as it defaults to false. With that done, we'll need to set its position in the graph and give it a size. Because I've already made this system, I already know what position and size I'll want. So type in minimap.setPosition, and this method accepts a rect, so we'll need to type in new rect, to which the x and y coordinates will be 15 and 50, and the width and height will be 200 and 180. Once that's done, we can add it to the graph view by typing in add and pass in minimap. We use the add method here instead of add element because minimap is a visual element and not a graph element. If we save, we shall now be able to see our minimap in the graph. However, it's not looking too consistent with the rest of our styles. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to update these styles through stylesheets, but we are able to update them through the style variable instead. So back in our DSGraphView script, go to our constructor, and right after our addStyles method, call in a new method we'll create named addMinimapStyles. I'll place it under our addStyles method in the elementsAddition region. We'll be updating the background color and the border color of our minimap. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to find a way to update the text color, as the color variable didn't seem to do the trick. Thankfully though, the text color is already yellowish, so it kinda fits our styles. We'll be creating style color variables and assign them to the respective style variables. So type in style color, and I'll name it background color. Then call its constructor and pass in new color 32, 29, 29, 30, and 255. I already have the codes I want transformed to RGB, but feel free to use your own. Duplicate this line by pressing Ctrl+C and then Ctrl+V, and swap the name to be border color instead. I'll make the RGB code be 51, 51, 51. Some editors might have different shortcuts to duplicate the line. Now that we have our colors in their own variables, we need to assign them. However, we can't really do that as we don't have a reference to our minimap, so we can't really update its style variable. To fix that, we'll be making our minimap be a global variable. So up above, in our variables, create a new private variable of type minimap and name it minimap. Then, in our addMinimap method, simply remove the minimap type from the minimap variable. Back to our addMinimapStyles method, we can now type in minimap.style background.backgroundColor equals to background color. With that done, all we need now is to update our border color. Unfortunately, the style variable does not provide us with the border color variable. Instead, we'll need to update all the border size colors. So type in minimap.style.border.top color and assign the border color variable to it. We'll need to do the same for the other three sides, so copy and paste the same line 3 times and swap the top with right, bottom, and left. If we save and go back to Unity, our minimap should now have its styles updated. We have our minimap working pretty well, but we'll also be making it so we can show it or hide it anytime we want through a button. To do that, let's set to our DSEditor window script. And in our hide toolbar method, we'll be creating a new last button which I'll name minimap button. Then create it by assigning to it dselementutility.createButton and pass in minimap as a text. When that's done, pass in an empty callback and call in a new method we'll be creating named toggleMinimap. I'll make it be part of our toolbar actions region. We'll be using this method to show or hide the minimap. Of course, because our minimap variable is placed in our DSGraphView script, we'll need to either pass the variable to the editor window constructor or simply create a public method in our GraphView script that we can use here. I'll go with the second option. So back to our DSGraphView script, in our utility methods region, create a new public method which I'll name toggleMinimap. Inside, we'll be setting the minimap visible variable to its opposite value. So if it was invisible, it will become visible. And if it was visible, it will become invisible. To do that, type in minimap.visible equals to not minimap.visible. This works because visible is of pool type. When that's done, go back to the DSEditor window script and in our toggleMinimap method, type in graphview.toggleMinimap. When that's done, don't forget to add the button to the toolbar in our addToolbar method. If we save and go back to Unity, we shall now be able to show or hide our minimap. There is one last thing we'll be doing though, and that's updating the button styles to have a yellow text color whenever the minimap is visible. Of course, we'll be doing that with style sheets. So in our editor default resources folder, in the dialog system folder, open up the ds-toolbar-styles-uss file. Under every other class selector, we'll be adding one for the selected buttons. So type in ds-toolbar __button_selected. We'll simply set its color to be var ds-colors window yellow. With our class selector created, let's head back to our DSEditor window script, and in our toggleMinimap method, we'll need to somehow add or remove this class from the button according to its visibility. Thankfully, there's an UnDivisible element method called toggleInClassList, which simply adds or removes a class we pass in, depending if the element already had a class or not. Of course, we need to use this in our minimap button, so above in our variables, create a new private button and I'll name it minimap button. Then remove the button type from the addToolbar method. Back to our toggle method, type in minimapButton.toggleInClassList and pass in ds-toolbar button selected. Do note though, that unless we call this method once, the button won't have the style whenever we open the window for the first time. We have two options here, either add the class when we create the button or start the button as invisible. I'll go with the second one. So in our DSGraphView script, in our addMinimap method, type in at the end minimap.visible equals false. If we now save everything and go back to Unity, our button should update the styles according to the minimap visibility.